Are you manually sending your form data to your monday.com projects? Well, Paperform now offers a direct integration with monday.com that will look after it automatically for you. So let's take a look. Hi everyone, Alex from the support crew at Paperform, and I'm excited to run through Paperform's direct integration with monday.com. Now with this integration, you can turn form submissions into tasks, update project fields, and even create workspaces, boards, and groups within your monday.com workspace. Now I've opted for using Paperform's project request form template for the sake of this video. It's a simple form that allows you to collect information to gain a scope of your client's projects. Now before setting up the integration, you'll want to ensure that you have run a test submission of your form. This is so the integration has real data to test the connection between your Paperform and your monday.com workspace. Once you've run a test submission of your form, it's time to jump into the editor and begin setting up the integration. So, from the form editor, you want to head up to After Submission, Integrations and Webhooks. Then, you'll want to scroll down until you see monday.com. Upon clicking that, you'll see the ability to create a workspace, a board, a group, or an item. Now, for our example, I'm going to simply create an item, which will merge my form submission over to my monday.com workspace. So I'll select that, then we'll be prompted to add our monday.com account. We'll click the button, and then we can see we're asked for the API key of our monday.com workspace. So we'll jump into our monday.com workspace, hit the avatar on the bottom left, and select developers. We'll select the drop-down menu developer and click my access tokens. All we need to do now is click show and then copy. Jump back into Paperform and simply paste our API key, then click connect monday.com. And connecting, voila. We've now connected our account. So let's continue setting up the integration, choose a workspace, choose a board, and of course, choose a group. Now we've done that, it's time to map our form fields over to our monday.com workspace columns. It's extremely simple. We'll notice that we have icons on the right-hand side of each of our columns or a simple drop-down menu. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select the icon there on the right-hand side of my name field. And what we'll see appear is a list of our form's question fields. What you need to do now is simply map which question field you want to populate which workspace column. So I'll go ahead, I'll select my name field for the name. Then I'm going to select company for the company field, email for the email field. And for the person that refers to my assignee, I'm going to leave that blank for now. I'm also going to leave the status blank. And then for the date column, I actually have a question that asks my submitter when they want their website project completed by, so I'm going to select that. Another awesome feature we can enable on our integration is the ability to set a logic rule. I'll show you what I mean. I'm going to toggle on use conditional logic, then I'm going to choose a particular question, this question being, do you agree to creating a project request? When the answer is yes, then this integration will be triggered to occur. If the submitter answers no to the question, do you agree to creating a project request? Then the system knows not to trigger this integration and the form response will not be sent to my monday.com workspace. Once we're happy with the setup, it's time to send a test. So we'll click send test and voila, there we have it. It's a success. So let's jump into our monday.com workspace and we can see that my test submission with the name Tony Stark, company Stark Industries, email tony@starkindustries.com and so on has been populated into that board there. It's easy as that. Now to finish off the setup, we'll jump back into our Paperform integration setup and just simply click the finish setup button and voila. If you scroll down, you'll see you have the ability to edit the integration, look at the history. You can also duplicate and delete that integration. If you don't want to delete the integration but don't want it to run, then simply click the toggle button there to turn it off. That's it. Easy, right? Now it's time for you to have a play around. Good luck and have fun creating.